Hello, my name is Brianne, and today I will be showing you how section breaks can be useful in the Windows version of Microsoft Word 2007. I've already opened Microsoft Word in a file that I have saved. To show the effectiveness of section breaks, I've opened my research paper from a previous class. Let's say I want to add a graph to my document, but the graph I found it needs to be on a page with a landscape instead of portrait orientation, because the graph is wider than it is tall. Many people think that in order for a page to have different orientation, the pages have to be in separate documents. But with section breaks, we can change orientation right in the middle of a document, and then change back again. Let's put our cursor where we want the graph to go. Then we go up to the menu bar at the top of Word and click on Page Layout tab. This will show you various options for how you can set up your page. In the Page Setup section, click on Breaks, which will show you a pull-down menu displaying the different kinds of breaks you might use. In this case, we're going to pick Next Page Break, located under the Section Break portion of the menu. This type of section break will take you to the next page where you can format differently than previous pages. Here we will insert the graph. Since we want this page to be landscape, we will go back to the Page Layout menu and click on Orientation to landscape the page. Now you must add another page break after the graph so that you can reorient the rest of your document back to portrait pages, and you can continue writing. So now that we have a graph in our document, maybe we decide that we have a long quote that we want to stand out from the rest of the print. You could indent the whole paragraph, or you could choose to put the quote into two columns. I'm going to show you two ways you can do this. If you're typing your document and decide you want two columns, put your cursor where you want to begin, and we'll pick a continuous section break this time. This will allow us to change the formatting on the current page without changing the rest of the formatting or adding a new or separate page as we did before. We'll go back to Page Layout in the tabs at the top where you can again find the Breaks menu. After you put in the continuous section break, you'll need to select the number of columns you want. Right next to the Breaks menu, you'll see the Columns menu where you can do this. I'm going to select two columns. Now you can begin to type and the words will show in the first column. When you have the desired text in that column, go back to the Breaks menu and choose a column break. This will allow you to begin typing in the next column. When you're finished with the column layout, you will need to put in another continuous section break so that you can continue typing in one column instead of two. There's another way to do this if you already have the information typed out like I do in my paper. All you need to do is highlight the section that you want to put into two columns. Go to the Page Layout tab and click on the Columns menu to select the number of columns you want. The program will automatically insert the necessary section breaks to format this section. Now let's move into a subject that often troubles students. Do you ever realize that you have headers and footers that need to be different for different sections of the same document, but you can't figure out how to change them? So in this case, you probably resorted to typing each section in a different Word document so that you can format the headers and footers differently. Then you need to remember where page numbers need to start for each document. Plus, if one document's page numbers change because you add or delete text from a page, you have to redo the numbers on every subsequent section. Well, now you can insert a section break and format various headers and footers within the same document. As you can see in my paper, I have different sections within the document. I've decided that I want a different header for each section so that the section name is also on top of each page. In this case, I'm also going to begin each section on a new page, which I can do in one easy step. First, I'll position my cursor at the beginning of a new section. Then I'll add a section break to start on a new page. As you can see, the new section automatically went to the next page. You can see, though, that this page has the same header still. Let's go back to the Header Design tab to find out why. If you look in the Navigation section, you can see that there is an orange box highlighting Link to Previous. This means that whatever settings the previous section has will also appear in this section. Since we don't want that, we'll go ahead and unmark it by clicking it. This section has to do with the definition of accelerated learners, so I'm going to abbreviate this by putting definition in the header on the right side of the page. I'm going to do the same thing for the next section. Since I already inserted a continuous section break here, I can change my header without having to add another section break. All we have to do is type in something different in place of definition in the header. Before you do this, though, don't forget to unlink from the previous section. Then, in this case, I'll type in characteristics. Now you have a new heading. As you can see, even though we're changing the words in the heading, the page numbers stay consistent. This is nice because you can add and subtract information without having to worry if your page numbers are correct. Now that you know how to use these section breaks, you'll be able to write professional papers without the hassle of using many documents and having to keep track of everything. Your whole paper will be in one easy place, easy to edit and print.